Love, light, and blessings, Shamanic Agwag Priestess here. And welcome to day 24 of 29 days of Melanated Excellence, guys. This is our last 5 days here. After today, 5 more videos, guys. Can you believe it? Anyway, so today's topic is La Mesa Blanca, aka the Ancestral Table, the White Altar. Aka the White Altar, let's say it like that. Mesa Blanca, aka the White Altar, okay, or the White Shrine, really, but we're going to move on from that. So basically, this is a space that's dedicated to, outside of going to the cemetery and visiting loved ones, that we commune with our familiar, so our familiares, or aka ancestros, okay? There's a difference between familiares and ancestros, and I do teach that in my class as well, so familiar and ancestors, okay? Familiar spirits. When I say familiar, I'm not talking about spirit animals, I'm talking about people. So familiars, familiar spirits, and ancestors, because there is a difference, okay? So this is where we go to connect with family. Some people have pictures they hang on the wall, some people put pictures. Traditionally speaking, I did not do any of those. My mom didn't do any of those, things like that. We did it in a different way with names and all of that. Okay, because most of the women that did have these altars were people that worked for the public. So they tried to keep who was actually housing these altars a secret for protection. Okay. But anyways, most important thing is everything in La Mesa Blanca is white. Everything in the white altar is white. Okay, when we're talking about espiritismo, everything, so spiritualism, okay? Espiritismo criollo. Everything in the altar is white. All. White cloth, okay? So I'm talking about the ATRs. White cloth of the diaspora, guys. White cloth, white tablecloth, white novena candle, okay? Before novena candles, we were using lanterns. So the gas lanterns, the lanterns, you know what I mean? That you could use for camping, you can use those. Has a white base, silver, gold, that is fine. They also sell the ones that are just clear glass. You can use that, a conjure lamp. You can use a man-made lampara. Modernly or more conveniently, people also use white candles, specifically novena candles, things like that. Okay, clear. Novena candles, copas, clear glass, no designs, cool water, always cool water, and things of that nature, and some type of a cross, whether it has Jesus on it or not. It's not about, yes, it's a way to honor any of our ancestors or familiar spirits that were of the Christian faith or went to church, but it also symbolizes the elements, the four corners, the opening the roads, just a lot of stuff. So that also is in La Mesa Blanca. This is traditionally a silver cross, okay? A silver cross. Then on top of that, okay, you have your, some people have actually bought like little glass white crosses. Those are fine too, the ones, as long as it's upright, okay? Some people put it over the cup, copa, that's fine too. I'm gonna actually have an older video to show you one of my setups for La Mesa Blanca. I'll try to link it to this video so you guys can see what I'm talking about. But basically everything in La Mesa Blanca is white. Is everything's white. There is spiritual significance to that. When an espiritista is doing una sesión, okay, when they're doing a session, okay, everybody traditionally is dressed in white, both men and women, okay. And things of that nature. The women are covering their hair. Men are at times covering their hair, depending. But everybody's dressed in white, moderate, okay? You have your mediums, okay, that are going to be in contact with these spirits who are going to help the community that is part of the ritual, just to help people with conditions, to petition on the behalf of others through the guías and all these kinds of things. Because that's what espiritismo is all about. It's about helping people. through these indigenous practices, through herbal and earth medicine. The intercessor, so the medium, is contacting spirits, is channeling spirits. Spirits are speaking directly to you. Family members who come through, die, you know what I'm saying? People that have passed on, things of that nature. A saint could come through, you know, a lot of things, like, you know, deities, whatever. Like, spirits, guias could come through. Okay, so that's really important to know. That is the purpose of it, to build that relationship, to elevate our ancestrals, okay? It's something that was done and created out of oppression, because we were no longer in our homelands. We could no longer go and contact our loved ones, or if we were of Native descent and they were colonizing our world, it was a way to connect to the ancestrals, because we were no longer free. Okay, people were buried in mass graves. Like, people were not respected when they were buried. Traditions and the way that things were traditionally done was disrespected. That's why La Mesa Blanca, the white altar, is so important, because if we look at the period of enslavement, colonization, mass murders, mass genocide, a lot, and even in recent history, a lot of our family members and ancestral spirits aren't buried. Ceremony isn't carried out, especially tragic deaths, in the way that we did traditionally prior to colonization. So this is a way to help those spirits that are unrested, helping to spirits to elevate, you know, communicating and contacting with these spirits that are housing your altar, become your guides. There's a separate type of shrine that's created for tranquil spirits that we help to elevate, that's separate from La Mesa Blanca. But La Mesa Blanca literally is a way to connect with family members that have passed on, to guide us, to elevate those family members who died tragically, who've died intranquilly, a way to help our communities. I remember doing una mesa for a client, and her child came through, a child that she lost, and she was able to have peace. And she was like, when you contacted, connected with this child, I saw my child, you know, and everything like that. So I felt like you were acting like it felt so genuine. And this is why this is so important. It gives people closure and peace. It's a beautiful practice. It's a beautiful tradition. And so, you know, that is different. Okay, so La Mesa Blanca, the white altar, is different. Then let's say if you're working voodoo tradition, okay, and we're talking about the Gede, you will have colors in those altars, right? Purples and black and red and white and all these things, because yes, while Gedes are cemetery spirits, it is a separate and different practice from La Mesa Blanca, okay? When you have La Madama, El Indio, and other types of ancestral spirits, the Orisha, other Loas and things like that, yes, you're going to have color correspondence. Again, these are different than La Mesa Blanca, which is traditionally all white. Because somebody had asked me, can you use other candle colors in your white altar? No, that's why it's called a white altar. Fresh flowers, white flowers are part of La Mesa Blanca, things of that nature. Everything on that altar, there's a symbology to it. This is why I did classes specifically about that practice, because too many times people are just telling you to do things, but I feel like it has more validity. The practice becomes more enhanced when we actually explain, or take the time to explain to people that are newly coming into these paths, why we do certain things. And so that's why I've made it my business, not just to learn how to do things, but research and learn even outside of my teachers and commune with spirit and do my due diligence, learning things from a historical perspective as well. I feel is important, because it helps to tie everything together, and therefore the practitioner has a better understanding of why we are carrying out these rituals, okay? So that's pretty much all I have to say about La Mesa Blanca. Just a quick no, it has to be a white candle when we're talking about that specific tradition and practice, which is outside of creating a gather altar. There's other people that use black candles, and that's fine. But when we're talking about the Mesa Blanca, the white altar, everything on the table, white, silver, clear. You know what I mean? Like silver cross, clear glass cup, so on and so forth, cool water, the plant, the light, you know, and all these things. They have spiritual meanings and a history linked to it, and it is part of a tradition. Okay, guys, so much love, much light, much blessings. Thank you so much for watching this video, and until the next video, guys, bye.